Start imagining its path as it comes in through your nose and down your throat, filling up your lungs. Try to deepen your breath now. Slower, longer. Inhale to the count of 4 and exhale to the count of 6. So inhale, 2, 3, 4. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Inhale, 2, 3, 4. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Inhale, 2, 3, 4. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Very good. Pressing both palms together, welcoming both sides equally into this practice today. Gently letting our chin come to our chest, getting a gentle stretch in our neck here. We're going to take a moment to set your intention for your practice today. And what does it mean to set your intention? What do you plan on getting from this practice? What are you going to put into this practice today? Is it about your physical well-being or your mental well-being? Maybe spiritual or emotional? Inhale, bringing our arms up to the sky. Exhale, let them float back down to the earth. Inhale. And exhale. On this inhale, we're going to drop our left hand to the earth. Let our right hand reach over our heads. Keeping our shoulders stacked, reaching towards the side. And come back up to center. Inhale, both hands up. Exhale, your right hand down. And reach over to your left side, keeping your shoulders stacked. Coming back up to center. exhale, bring your right hand down to your left knee, left arm behind us, and gently look over that left shoulder. Hands planted gently on our knees. We're going to start rotating our rib cage to the right in circles. And really imagine, if you're familiar with the pose, cat-cow. As you come to the center, arch our back as if you're in cow, coming around. And when you go to the back, we're in cat. Opposite direction. And come into a neutral spine in the center. As you exhale, we're going to reach our hands to the earth in front of us and then gently fold forward. Our all fours for a tabletop position. Move around here a little bit with the movement in our hips while we check our alignment. Our hips and knees should be directly in line. Knees should be hip distance apart. Our wrists should be directly below our shoulders. Keep those fingers nice and spread so you don't have too much pressure on your wrists. And let's try that cat-cow breathing here. As we inhale deeply, dropping our belly, extending our spine, looking forward. Exhale as we tuck in our tailbone. In our chin to our chest. Spreading our hips as wide as your yoga mat and drop our hips back to our heels, stretching our hands out in front of us in an extended child pose. eyes follow your hands. And on this last time, our arm's going to come all the way through underneath that left arm so you can rest on your right shoulder. Your right cheek will be on your mat. Left hand reaches out above our head. Walk that hand back in so you can come back up to our tabletop position. And we'll repeat this on the other side. Left hand reaches up to the sky, following it with your head if you're able. Let it swing through. And now on your fourth one, we'll go all the way through. Rest on that left shoulder and our left cheek. Back up to our tabletop position. We're going to extend our right leg out, toes pointing down. Our left arm will reach forward with our thumb up to the sky in a balancing table. Bring it back to our tabletop and go to the opposite side. Left leg out, right arm out. And we're going to do this with our breath. So as you inhale, we'll extend. Exhale, bring everything back to our tabletop. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Now we're going to add a little bit on this one. So we're going to extend and then bend our back leg up as hard as you can. Extend. Back leg, extend, and down. Last one on this side. We did one final little thing. Go back, extend straight, bend that foot in. Now take your left hand, take your left hand and reach back for your foot into a balance. Back to our tabletop. We're going to tuck our toes under, pushing our pelvis up to the sky in our first downward facing dog. So with down dog, our ears are pressing towards in between our elbows. Our hands are still nice and spread. Our gaze is in between our feet. Really try to keep our pelvis reaching for that sky. Knees can be bent if they need to be. If you can straighten them, Your heels can be reaching towards the earth. We're going to walk our hands back to our feet and come into a forward fold. Now again with forward fold, knees can be bent this first time. Feet can be yogi's choice if you want them to be touching. I have mine still hip distance apart. And our upper bodies come completely ragdoll heavy. And vertebrae by vertebrae, we're going to slowly roll up to Tadasana, mountain pose. Feel the energy going down in the back. Tuck that tailbone in. Feel it coming up the front. Engage those thigh muscles. Pull in your core. Shoulders down and back. Inhale our arms up. Really feel that energy flow now from our toes all the way out our fingertips. Opposite movement we did to come here. So our arms are going to reach out in front of us. And our head's going to get heavy and roll down. One vertebrae at a time. Until we come to our forward fold. We're going to walk our hands back out. But instead of just downward dog, you're going to come all the way to plank. Now with plank, your shoulders should be slightly over your wrists. Make sure that your tailbone is tucked so you're in a nice straight line. Your gaze is about 6 inches in front of your hands. Okay, now go ahead and walk those back to a forward fold and slowly roll up. Arms coming as well, reaching all the way up to the sky, feeling that flow of energy. And back down. Walk our hands out. Come to plank. Walk the hands back. Forward fold. Roll up. Arms reaching all the way up to the sky. Hands coming down, rolling down. This is your last one. Make it a good one. One vertebrae at a time. Walk those hands out. Watch that tailbone. Back up. And slowly roll up. Good job. Hands following. Right hand is going to gently grasp our left wrist. And you're going to pull to a gentle side stretch towards the right. Gently pull to the left. And come back up to center. Let our hands come open. Reaching back behind us, clasping can't quite clasp your hands behind you, go ahead and put your hands on your hips. Have your hands clasped, let them fall up and over your head. Release your hands. And our hands are going to walk us out to downward facing dog this time. Glide all the way to plank. Make sure you reposition your body. Feel that stretch. From down dog, we're going to plant that left foot, raise your right, and a three-legged dog. You're going to tuck that knee in towards your chest. Make sure you pull those abs in. Let that right foot come in between your hands into a runner's lunge. Right on our fingers, so you can look up. Down, drop our back knee, and with control, lift up to a crescent. Release our hands. Lift our back knee. Plant our left hand. Right hand twists up. Look towards it. Right hand comes down. We turn our right foot back to our left into our downward facing dog. Same thing other side. Plant that right foot, lift our left, and a three-legged dog. Tuck that knee towards your chest, really pulling your abs in, and swing that foot forward. Light on our fingers, look forward. Back down, drop our back knee, with control, lifting up, arms up, into a crescent lunge. Release your hands down, lift your back knee, plant your right hand so your left hand can come up in a twist. Left hand comes down. Bring your left foot back to meet your right. Downward facing dog. Walk your feet up to your hands. Return to our forward fold. Inhale as we slide halfway up to make a flat back. Forward fold. Inhale, root to rise. Bring our hands down to our heart center. And breathe. So right foot all the way back to a lunge. Left foot comes back to meet the right in a down dog. Drop our hips to our plank and then lower to the earth. Now our arms, our hands are going to be directly below our shoulders. And on your inhale, going to push up into a cobra pose. We'll inhale, and when you get to the top of your pose, look forward and exhale down. Inhale, forward, exhale. Last last one. Keep that chin tucked as you come up. Press back up to your plank position into our downward facing dog. Right, left foot plants as our right foot raises to our three-legged dog. Going our knee towards our chest, swing that foot through. Gently look forward, release. Drop your back knee, return to our crescent lunge. Release our hands, we slide down along your mat, shifting your weight to your back knee, straightening your front, pulling those toes up off of the earth, and gently try to relax down to your knee in a half split. Shift back to the front of your mat. Lift that back knee. Left hand planted. Twist with your right hand. Right hand down. Right foot comes back to meet our left. Downward facing dog. Same thing, other side. Plant that right foot. Left foot raises in a three-legged dog. Tuck that knee in towards our chest. Swing it all the way through. Low lunge. Looking forward. Release our back knee. Crescent lunge. Release. Swing all the way through, shifting our weight to the back knee. Straightening the front leg. Pulling those toes up off the earth, knee and nose towards the earth. Half split. Shift our weight to the front. Lift that back knee. Right hand plants. Left hand goes into our twist. Left hand comes down, left foot comes back to meet our right in our downward facing dog. Step to walk our feet up to our hands, forward fold. Inhale halfway up to a flat back, exhale forward fold. Inhale root to rise, pull that energy down. Don't forget to smile. Heart center. Now. Inhale. Exhale, forward fold. And then step back to your, with your left foot this time. Low lunge. And then your right foot meets so you can go into your down dog. Then into your plank. Lowering and going up to your cobra. Lower back to your ground. You can either push up to your downward facing dog or directly into your plank. And then into your downward facing dog. Inhale, our right foot up into our three-legged dog. Tuck that knee into our chest. Swing that foot all the way through. This time we're going to stay up. So plant that back foot in a 45 degree angle so we can come up into a warrior one. It's a little bit harder on the sand. From warrior one, we're going to come down to our warrior two. Make sure that front knee doesn't go over our ankle in the front. Make sure our arms are nice and even. Look over your front hand. feel our hands down. Bring our right foot back to meet our left in a downward facing dog. Left foot up in a three-legged dog. Swing that leg through. Plant that back foot in a 45-degree angle. So you can come up to a warrior one. Arms up to warrior two. Part with our arms down. Left foot comes back to meet the right in a downward facing dog. We'll do our flow once again. So step, a walk, your feet up to your hands. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway up to a flat back. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, root to rise. Both feet back, one at a time, so right lunge, and then to our downward facing dog. Drop both knees to our tabletop position. Bring our right knee in between our hands. And then you can scooch that foot so that it becomes more parallel to the short end of your mat, extending that back leg into a pigeon pose. Now there's lots of variations on this that I encourage you to try. Try to stay upright for a little bit, see how that feels. Like to go down onto their elbows. See how that feels? Some people like to go all the way down with their forehead onto the mat. Your way back up to an upright position. Readjust to a down tabletop position, please. So move back. Make sure we're hip distance apart. Engage that core, pushing out of our shoulders. Forward in between our hands. That foot will scooch it so you feel comfortable. The more you get into your practice, the more parallel that foot will become with that front mat. Extend that back leg. And try the three different positions. So stay upright for a moment. On your elbows. And then if you want to go all the way, arm. We're going to find ourselves in our easy pose once again. So this is the part of our practice where we would go into Shavasana. Shavasana is the most important part of a yoga practice, and it's also the most difficult part. You can do Shavasana in any position that you want. So if you find yourself laying back and relaxing everything in that position, that's the most common. Since we're here in front of the ocean, I'm going to take a moment to do my reflection, my letting go, taking in the waves. So thank you so much for joining this practice. Allow yourself several minutes here to contemplate, to reflect on, to revisit your intention for joining this practice today. Thank you so much for coming. Pressing both palms together.